Hello friends, welcome once again to another video related to Google Ads or Google AdWords. In this video, you will learn how to set up Google Shopping Ads in 2021. So this is June 2021 when I am creating this video and I am giving you instructions to create shopping ad. Now, what are shopping ads? In order to see shopping ads, let's go to Google and simply search. Let's say I search laptop here. So when you will search a query in which you have information about some product, so Google will show you ads on the basis of your keyword. So in these advertisements, you can see they are different from the search advertisements, the text search advertisements, because in these advertisements you can see the images of the product, there you can see their brand name, their product name and their price. Also, you can see their rating. So this is called a shopping ad. And in order to create a shopping ad, first of all, you have to create an account on Google Merchant. So you have to make a Google Merchant account where you can list your products for free, and using Google Merchant with Google AdWords, you can connect Google Merchant and Google AdWords to create shopping ads. So in the first part of this video, we will learn how to set up Google Merchant Center account. So this is the Google Merchant Center accounts page. Now, or you can click here. So let me do it from start. So here on Google Merchant Center page, simply click on sign in, and from here go to sign in to Merchant Center. This will open a welcome page where it will ask you to list your products for free on Google. So Google has some rich results for e-commerce websites, for product websites. So you can list your products for free on Google. And again, as I said, Google Merchant Center can also be used to create shopping ads. Now simply scroll down and here mention your business name. So for demonstration and educational purpose, I have simply created a simple store here and I have uploaded one sample product that is called Kasba Shampoo 200 ml. So this is just a simple product, and in this product, let's say the price of this product is 400. Again, this is just for educational purpose. This is not a real product. So now I have uploaded this product on this website, which is called digiworld.gq. So I will enter the name here, digiworld.gq. From here, you have to choose your business country. So I will choose business country as India. The time zone will automatically be selected. Now, here are the two things. First thing is, where do you want your customers to check out? So if you want your customers to check out on your website, that means the online store that you have, so you can use the first option. If you have a physical store available, so you can also use at my local store here. So as you can see, if you have listed your business on Google, so it will show something like this, 1.2 mi in stock at San Jose. So it will mention name of your business and location here. So I'm not setting up this because I just want my customers to check out on my website. From here you can see if you have these tools. I have created my website using WordPress WooCommerce. If you have created your website using Shopify, or maybe you have integrated PayPal, so you can use these tools also, but I'm not using these tools, so I will skip this. Here you can see, would you like to sign up for emails about Google Merchant Center? It's your choice. You can look for updates. They will send you invitations to test new features also. From here, you have to read the Google Merchant Center's terms of service. I have already read these services and I agree to them. So it's good if you also read these services, terms and services, and then if you agree, you simply click this checkbox and move ahead. From here, simply click create account. Your account will be created and you can see, great, your account is now ready to use. click on continue. Now the first thing comes to you is free listing setup. So free listing setup is for creating the rich results, free product listing results. But this time, because our goal is to set up shopping ads, we will cancel this setup. So it is simply asking for tax related information, shipping, website, products and so on. So we will cancel these setups, cancel this particular setup, and then we will move ahead. Now when you will reach this dashboard of Google Merchant Center, here you will see these options: free product listing, shopping ads, buy on Google, free local product listing, customer reviews, dynamic remarketing, local inventory promotions, product ratings, so on. So in this case we have to choose shopping ads because we are creating shopping ads. Make sure the name of your country is written there. So now in shopping ads, we can see we have the similar options as free listing, but there are more options here. First of all, it is asking us to mention tax related information. So go to setup tax. Here you will see you appear to not have a business address in United States. So we are proposing this tax setup for you. So it is not showing anything here. But if you are in United States, so you can click on your tax and you can check with your tax advisor before you make settings here. But we don't have to do any tax related settings. We will again click continue to shopping ads. Then you have to set up your shipping. So here you have to mention the name of your shipping service. So some of my clients are using ShipRocket service. So suppose the name of your service is ShipRocket, or it can be any service from which or you are using this service to deliver your products to your customers. You have to mention name of the service provider here. And then in countries, choose your country. You can add more countries here also. Which countries can you deliver to with this service? So you can add any number of services here also. Suppose for local service, suppose for delivering local products or delivering products to local customers, you use different service, and for delivering products to international customers, you use different type of service. So you can use any number of services. The main purpose of using these services is how much. First of all, you have to select time zone. So this is order cutoff time. This simply means order cutoff time allow you to set a time after which you will no longer process orders received on that particular day. For orders processed after cutoff time, one day will be added to the delivery time estimate. So let's say after 10 p.m. we don't process orders, and here you have to select your time zone. So GMT plus 05. I'm sorry about the noise. So you have to choose your time zone. So in my case it is GMT plus 5:30. So in my case it is GMT plus 5:30 India Standard Time, Kolkata. Choose your order cutoff time and your time zone after which you don't process orders. This is handling time. This simply means that handling time is the difference between the order cutoff time and following placement of order and when the shipment for the order is ready for transit. That means you hand your products to your carrier. So in handling time, let's say handling time takes 0 to 1 days to get fulfilled, and we work from Monday to Saturday. And then there is transit time. That is the time that your shipping company takes to deliver the products after you have handed the product to your shipping company. So this is the transit time. You can read here. Transit time is the time it takes the carrier to deliver a product to a customer. So let's say this is 2 to 7 days. Again, I'm just using some random examples here. This may not be the real case. It may differ in your case. So choose accordingly. And now click on next. This is the amount that you take for shipping. Suppose you have a flat rate. How much do you take for shipping? Or you can set range also. For example, for products ranging between 100 rupees to 500 rupees, we take 50 rupees, and then you can add another range and so on. Let's say in our case, we are using free shipping table here, and we will save this. Now you can see one shipping company is now saved here, and this simply means whatever prices we will enter on our website, those prices will be MRP, maximum retail price, and shipping charges and taxes and everything will be included in those charges, and we will manage those things on our end. Customers will have to pay that particular amount which is mentioned here. So for example, with this sample product, the charges are 400 rupees. So these are the maximum retail charges. Customers don't have to pay anything more than this from wherever they are ordering this product. And you have to manage your shipping and other type of zones using your website settings. So now we have set up this thing, and either you can add other shipping services or you can view these shipping services. You can come back later to add these services also. Now this thing is done, and now we have to go back to Google Merchant Center, and we have now verify and claim your store's website. This is an important step. This might come at any point in your setup. So first of all, you have to mention your website's name here. So we are using this dummy website here, which is called digiworld.gq, and simply go here and type the name of your website. Make sure it is HTTPS, because if you are using payment and if you are taking payment from users, you might need this SSL certificate. But if your website is HTTP, you have to mention the HTTP version. If it's HTTPS, you have to mention the HTTPS version. Now it is checking whether it can verify this website or not. So the verification code is not added yet on this website. So all you have to do is add an HTML tag here. So here you can see meta tag and name, everything is given here. This is a verification method. A meta tag is basically added in the head part of the website. So for example, we have meta description, meta keywords, meta author, meta title, which is used for search engine optimization. And meta tags are also used for telling search engines whether to crawl this page or not. So these tags can be read by search engines and these type of services. So now in my website, because it is developed using WordPress, so in my website I will go to appearance, and from here I have to go to themes, and you have to find theme editor in your website. So go to theme editor, and in theme editor you have to check for header.php. So if you are using WordPress, in WordPress you have to choose header.php. So just place your code here. If you are using any other programming language or any other tool to develop your website, so you have to ask your developer to look for that particular part of your code in which you have information of the head, and make sure you add this meta tag in the home page of your website. For example, in most, if your website is developed using PHP, so the home page is index.php. If it is created using HTML, the home page is index.html. In some cases, in ASP.NET, the home page is default.aspx. So for different programming languages, the home page is different, but ask your developer where the head part of HTML is located on your home page. So in your home page, enter this meta tag. There are other methods also for verification, but we are using this particular method. So it is giving me some warning. Let me check. So now my page is updated. So I have pasted the meta tag here. So if you are not familiar with these settings, so you might need to get some professional help here. You can contact your developer. But if you know where the head part of your index page is, so you can paste this code. Then go back to your web merchant center, and from here you have to click on verify the website. So you will click on verify website, and Google will look for that meta tag. So it has found that meta tag, that's why the domain is now verified. But you have to claim your website also. So click on claim website. Remember, if your website is claimed by some other account, so you might get a warning here that this particular domain is also claimed by that account. So now you are kind of overwriting the settings. So now this is claimed, and now we can go to branding part. So in the branding part, you have to upload two logos here. First logo should be of 500x500 pixels minimum, and 2000x2000 pixel maximum. This should be a square logo, and another logo will be rectangular logo. So I have already created some sample logos for this particular business, so I will upload them. So I have uploaded these logos. One is a square and another is rectangular. Also, you can provide information about main color. That is, choose a color that is same as the background color of your logo. So the background color of my logo is white, and code for white is 3x or 6x F. So you can write 3x F also. This is your white colors code. Then you have to choose a color for choose an accent color that best represents your brand and is different than the main color. The color is used to align your ads with your branding preferences. So I can choose black color here. 000 is the code for black. Again, this is simple HTML color codes. So you can go to htmlcolorcodes.com, and from there you can find these colors. And these are my two logos. Again, you might need help with your logo designer, and you have to ask them to create logos in these two sizes. You can see it is under review. So Google will take 2 to 3 days to review your logo, and then once your logos are approved, your branding will be set up here. Now you have to write some information about your business. So this is address, line 1, let's say Gola. Address, city is Lucknow, state is Uttar Pradesh, postal zip code is 26018. Again, you have to mention the address where your business is located so that Google can verify it. The next thing is you have to provide customer service contact for shopping ads, a URL where they can contact you, some email address and a phone number where they can contact your customer care. So here you have to mention your phone number. So whatever your phone number is, so I will mention my phone number. Google will send a text to my phone number, and then my phone number will be verified. Now I'm going to do that step. So you can see here my phone number is verified. This is a very simple process. Google will send you a SMS, or it can call you with automated voice also, so that you can verify your phone number. Now our website is verified and claimed. Our branding is also done here. We have uploaded the logos and we have mentioned information about business. Now it's time to add some products in our Google Merchant Center account. So simply click on this Google Merchant Center logo. It will take you back to this dashboard. From here you can continue your shopping ads, and here you will see that your shipping service is added, your website URL is provided, and you have to add product data. Now to add product data, there are two things that you can do. First thing is you can upload multiple products. So to upload multiple products, some expert need is there, means you can use an API, you can use a feed to upload multiple products, but as a beginner we are adding a single product here. So click on add products. It will ask you the same details that are asked while adding products in your website. So first thing is country of sale, then the language, then what is the destination of this particular product. Destination let you choose which Google products and properties can use the items in your data feed. So you are creating a data feed here and you are saying that this data feed can be used by shopping ads in Google AdWords. Now the next thing is identifier exist. So identifier is GTIN or MPN or a brand. You have to check if your product has an identifier, that means if it has GTIN number or MPN number. You can uncheck this box also. So we are going to uncheck this because we don't have identifier for this product. Here you have to mention the ID or SKU. SKU is a stock keeping unit. So if you have unique IDs or SKUs associated with your products, you can mention that information here. Otherwise you can leave it empty. Here you have to mention the title. So again you can see for our sample product, again I am mentioning this is not a real product, this is a sample product. So for our product we are mentioning the title. In your case, whatever products you have uploaded on your website, so you have to mention the title of that product. Then you have to mention the name of brand. So let's say the name of brand is Kasba. We are mentioning the brand, and it is not mandatory to mention the brand. You can see brand is the publicly recognized name of the company. So I can choose my own website's domain name also. So I am using this domain name as brand, dizzyworld.gq. Here is the description. So we have written some points here. So from those points we are writing this description. So I have written a description here. You can see you can write up to 5000 characters here. So make sure that you write as much as information as you can. Now this is the link of landing page. Here you can see this is the link of our landing page. Landing page is simply that page where your customers will land after clicking the advertisement, and the page from where they can buy the product. So you can see from this page they can add to cart and then they can proceed with checkout process. So your landing page will be the your product's information page, from or the page where you have button to buy your product. This is the image link. So either you can upload the image, either you can drop your image file here, or you can click on browse and you can upload your image, or you can provide your image link here. So I'm going to provide image using this. You can use image link also. Here you can see if your images are non-April image, so it should be 100 into 100 pixels. And if you are selling apparels like clothing apparels, so your image should be at least 250 into 250 pixels. Your image should not be more than 64 megapixels, and your image file should not be larger than 16 megabytes. So I have uploaded the image of product that I uploaded here. You can also right click on this product and you can copy the image link, and then you can mention that image link here. So you can see the product image is added. Make sure in your product image you have a white background, or the concept is your product image should be clearly visible. The background should be such that, or your product should be placed such that it is clearly visible. Now, and also on your products, on your image of your product, your brand should also be written clearly. So you can do that. Now we have a price here. So price is 400. Availability is in stock. And your condition, whatever product's condition is, you can sell used or refurbished products also. In our case, it is new. If you have apparel, so suppose you have different sizes, colors, and you have products available for different genders and age groups, so you can create these variants also. But here we are not creating any variant because it's a simple product. And you can set some additional product data also, for example product category or shopping campaign, but these are optional things, so we are not creating them. Now simply save. After you will hit save, you will see that your product information will be shown to you. You can add new product, or you can go to your products and see all the available products. Now Google will take some time. So as you can see here, this product is in review. So this here, you currently you are seeing zero total products. You can go to diagnostics, and here you can see active items in green, expiring items in orange, pending items and disapproved items. So Google is actually taking some time to review our products data, and once the product review is complete, so you will be able to see the status of your product here. And again, you can go back to overview, and currently you can see because our account is new, so we don't have information about shopping ads or anything. So after this step, you have to give it some time. It will take some time to review your products data. It will take some time to review your business information and branding information. So if, you can go to your branding information, and it will take some time to review your logos and everything. And once everything is done, you will be able to see your products. When you will go to your products part, you will be able to see your products under active product. And if something is missing, or if something is wrong with the data that you have provided, so you will see that message. So again, this is the first part of this video where we have just mentioned the product data and everything. And in the second part of this video, you can see clearly here there are some account issues. Account isn't eligible for enhanced free listings. So you can see our account is not eligible for enhanced free listing. If you will click here, you will, and if you will click on learn more, so you will be redirected to Google support. So one or more of your product is ineligible for free enhanced listings. This could be due to a number of reasons. So all the reasons are listed here. So, but we have to give some time to our Merchant Center account. And also no Google Ads account are linked. So you have to create Google Ads account. So you just go to Google Ads. So google.com or you can type ads.google.com, and from here sign in. Make sure you are signing in with the same account that you have used to create your Merchant Center account. If you already have Google Ads account, so you have to log in to that Google Ads account. I don't have any Google Ads account, so I'm going to create an ad account here. So by default it will give you this smart mode. We don't want a smart mode, we want to switch to expert mode. Again, these are the settings of Google AdWords as per June 2021. You can see you have to create some campaign or other things here. So campaigns are basically your marketing campaigns, and they depend upon your goals. Suppose you want to sell products, so shopping ads come under sales goal. But for now we will create an account without a campaign. So we will create our Google account without campaign. It will ask you for billing country, your timing zone, your currency and everything. So set that. Congrats, you are all done. Now you can explore your account. So we are inside our account, and this account is created without adding any campaign. Now from here you have to click on this tools and settings icon, and here you will see different sort of options, and from here you will see linked accounts, and you will also see Google Merchant Center. So you can click on Google Merchant Center from there also, and you will simply load to your Google Merchant Center, but you have to link this account. So go to linked accounts, and here you will see different sort of options. So you can link your Google AdWords account with your Google Analytics, you can link with Google Analytics, G4 and Firebase, Google Play, Salesforce, Google Hotel Center, and so on. Also with YouTube, you can link it with Search Console, which is also known as Google Webmasters, to fetch your organic results. But we have to check on Google Merchant Center. Click on details, link Google Merchant Center to Google Ads. To link your Merchant Center account, send a request from Merchant Center. Okay, so you can see that to link it, you have to send a request from Merchant Center, and when you will send that request, so that request will be visible here. And when you will come back to your Google Merchant Center, here also you will see linked accounts. So you can, when you will see linked accounts, you will see that Google Ads in this first tab, display and video 360, Google My Business, partner and platform. So you have to choose this first tab, Google Ads. So to again, once again, to come here, click on this gear icon, go to linked accounts. Here you can see we have Google Ads customer ID listed here. Customer ID is 7112880623. So customer ID is written like this, and that simple, that particular customer ID is written here also. So just click on link. So we have account link. So we have created a request from Google Merchant Center. Now let's reload this. And here you can see we have received a request here, and here you have to click on view details, and now you can approve it. So now your Google Merchant Center account and your Google Ads account are now linked. Reload this. You can see active. Now we can go back to Google Merchant Center, you can go back to products, and you will see product in account issues, it is again showing this pending, so it takes some time to refresh. And now you have to give it some time so that it can fetch data of the products. As you can see, we have already uploaded one product here. So you can see the image is now here, and this is the information. Here you can see the status is pending. So now next time when we will create another video, in that video we will show you whether Google approved our product or not, disapproved our product or not, and if it will approve our product, so we will see how we can create a new campaign with sales goal and a campaign with a shopping ad. So all that will be covered in the next part of this video.